What's going on, team? It's your boy G, aka Genato Sensei. We back at it again with another episode of Stamp or Not. Today's episode, we're going to be talking about Jupiter's Legacy. Let's get it. All right, y'all. So Jupiter's Legacy is a show that came out on Netflix maybe like last week or something like that, and it's going crazy. So like I do with most shows, I've gotten through, you know, about three episodes of this show, and it's only about eight. So you know, this is a good portion of it. It's a good like first arc, and this show is tough, bro. I'm not even gonna fake. Like, I know that I've been, you know, excited about shows in the beginning a lot lately. This one for sure, like, I know, bro. I know it's gonna be good, because not only are like the episodes pretty long, but they actually spend time with developing these characters, because this is a live action like superhero show, you know. And usually when we see these live action shows like for superheroes and stuff, it's Marvel, it's DC. I don't know anything about Jupiter's Legacy, but let me actually give a shout out to the person that put me onto the show. Shout out to Wayno. He got a new podcast that's out. Just search Wayno and it'll pop up on YouTube. But they was talking about, he was saying that he thinks that this show is going to be good. So I was like, bro, let me check this joint out, you know, because after seeing Invincible and everything like that, it's got me on a superhero like wave, you know. So to start off, you know, the show is basically going to be about a family, but, you know, extended family. So extended family of superheroes and possibly super villains. I don't really know yet, but superhero power world, but it doesn't start that way. It starts off in like the 1920s and back in the day, right before the stock market crash. So they flip-flop in between back in the day to, you know, what's going on currently there right now. And I love that because it gives you a different perspective on the characters that not only we're going to be getting introduced to, but it's a good way for us to, you know, get an understanding of like the world that we're living in, right? So this isn't some made-up place, you know what I'm saying? They're talking about the U.S.
This is America.
Like, that's their home. So yes, this show is about superheroes and stuff like that, but I think it's gonna be a little bit more, you know, because for me, I'm waiting to see how they got their powers and, you know, how their powers are really gonna be transferring and stuff like that, because there's an actual like league, like, you know, it's like a Justice League in this, and they hinted at league members that had left before. We're getting introduced to so many characters as we go along, bro, that I'm actually starting to get, you know, a real attachment to. And like Invincible, this show is pretty gory, but not like to that extent, because granted, this joint is, you know, live action and there's CGI and stuff like that, but they even definitely spent some money on this show. As young as we get body, and when I say body, I mean body, bro. And now up until this point that I have seen it, like the big bad has not really been revealed, but we are starting to see basically how the initial ideals of what a superhero is supposed to be is changing, and it's being changed because of the way that the villains are acting. The villains are stepping up their game, whole world is changing with it, and the main superhero this world is basically Superman the Utopian. And I can already see like his story, you know, is definitely gonna have a huge effect on where the show goes in the future, because at this point they're setting up the story to, you know, be passed on to the son, whose name is Brandon, basically, you know, trying to get good enough to take up the mantle of being the Utopian. And then you have this, you know, not just him, but a group of young heroes that are basically doing the same thing. So where I think that, you know, the name, you know, Jupiter's Legacy, if we actually get more into that, I think that's where, you know, this joint is really going to turn up. Because right now, all I'm really curious about is how everybody got their powers, along with, like, you know, who is the big bad and stuff like that. I plan on finishing this joint this week, so you guys will probably get a review either on Saturday or Monday. So definitely be on the lookout for that. Other than that, that's all I really got for this episode of Stamp or Not. If you can't tell already, bro, I'm already stamping this joint because this joint is fire, bro. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If y'all did, slap that like button down below. Or subscribe to the channel for more. We're on the road to 1,000 subscribers, and any and every bit of love to the channel really helps the channel grow, man. I'm going to get up out of here. Y'all know the vibes. Also, girl, it's going to be your boy G. Peace.